Good morning, welcome back to another video. Today's a training edition, so we're going to go and train posterior. We got Saturday today, so posterior day. Hamstring, glutes, back, biceps. Take you through the session, explain what we're doing, because the setup has changed a bit. There's a few new movements in there that weren't in there before, so I can talk you through them. It's currently 5:45 in the morning, so we've just done meals for tomorrow's rest day. So they're all boxed off. Well, three out of six are boxed off. Three out of seven. The rest we can just do on the go. So I'm about to leave now, get to the gym for six, and start from there. So I'll talk you through the session while we're doing a few steps before we get into the session. Intro this morning is 100 gram of carbs, still 5 gram of creatine, 10 gram of essential amino acids. I had my Systole Max, one scoop of Systole Max and two scoops of electrolytes this morning. So I had that with about 500 to 700 milliliters of water, just to start the day off and get the brain functioning, get back on some hydration after we wake up, and pretty much ready to go. Packed a post-workout meal, and pretty much set. So I will see you at the gym, talk through the session, and go from there. So first things first, I will get on the treadmill for about 5 minutes. Literally just on a slow walk, really just for a mental state, just have a look around the gym, get my mindset into the session, think about which movements I'm going to go into, what I need to do for each movement. So I'm kind of just going to talk out loud for what I'm thinking today. So first, I'll talk you through the session. First movement in, we're going to go leg curl, lying leg curl. Second movement in, we go on to the glute drive, which was our main heavy compound for today, which was really good last week, so looking forward to that. After that, we're going to a hyperextension with dumbbells, and then into, that's kind of our hamstrings and glutes, and then into our back session, which is single arm Nautilus pull down, so hitting more the lats. Then we'll come upstairs and do the upper back VR2 row, which is upper back. And then that's kind of it for back. Only two movements on back, because we've done a core session already this week, so this is kind of like a little touch up of the areas that we need to improve on, which is hamstrings. Well, this phase is quads, but we always want more hamstrings, and then we always want more back. So that's back, two moves from back. And then into our bicep work. So we'll do the cables, so low handle cables with the D handles, and then into a incline bench dumbbell curl, two hands dumbbells, and that's kind of it. That'll finish it off. So I'll take you through the session. Probably talk in between, tell you what's going on set wise, and a bit about the set and what we're hitting. But yeah, I'm gonna go for 5 minutes on here, just get warmed up, because it's about probably like 5 or 6 degrees in here this morning, pretty cold. So get warmed up and then get onto our first movement, which is the lying leg curl. So first movement in is our lying leg curl. We'll go into one top set on this and one back off. What I like to do on this is get a 2 second squeeze at the top of the movement, and like a 3 or 4 second eccentric on the way down, just to provide more tension to the hamstrings, especially now as this is our first movement in, so we're just warming up and getting into the session. So taking it easy on the way up, one top set, one back off, and then we'll move on. So next movement in is our plate loaded glute drive, the Nautilus. The same again, we'll go one set on this, one top set, and one back off. Tempo on this has changed the past, well, this going into this phase. It's like a 3 second eccentric, 2 second hold, 2 second squeeze. So really trying to make the most out of the load we're putting on, and get the most out of the movement for these sets going in now. So this is like our main compound now of the session, main heavy one for glutes and hamstrings. So going into our last glute and hamstring movement, which is going to be the hyperextension with dumbbells, two dumbbells. You'll see that it's quite a short range of motion. That's only because we're trying to target glutes and hams. Take the back completely out of it, so we need to round the shoulders when we got the dumbbells in hand. Keep the shoulders rounded, which will hit our glutes and hamstrings, and just take our upper back and lower back out of it, because we're not trying to hit that. So this is our last movement for glutes and hams, then we'll move on to our two back movements. Glute drive went well, top set was good, failed on eight. Well, I got eight up, but wouldn't have been able to do nine, so happy with that. We'll increase loads slightly next week and go for a six to seven. But now onto these hypers. Again, I think it's two working, one back off. So two dumbbells in hands with this one. So into our back movements now, two back movements. We've got our single arm pull down on the Nautilus, and then the Nitro, and then we'll work up to a good top set on this, good top set, good back off, and then go from there really. This is our lat movement, and then we go into another back movement, like I said at the start, and then into biceps. So in terms of improving weaknesses, I think putting a session in like posterior, like I am now, or if you need more chest, putting another push session in, very beneficial, because you can target. Yeah. So second back movement we're going into now is a VR2 upper back row. So obviously hitting our upper back. Now we've hit our lats. We want to hit that upper back, and it's probably one of my weaknesses is my upper back and the middle of my upper back. So this machine really targets it and really get good connection with it. So hoping this is going to bring it up. It's been in the plan now for a couple of weeks. It's our new phase, which is still in. So we're trying to make the most of it. This is our last back movement, so we're going top set on this, back off set. Could be two top sets. I need to check, but squeeze the back, having the seat low, keeping elbows high, trying to drive in a straight plane across your back. So we're trying to drive in that way instead of down, which targets more lats. We're going to drive across and back. We're just going to hit all across our upper back. So we're going to get into this now. Show you top set, maybe back off, and then into biceps. So the main thing that I found doing these, as you can see, as I'm leaning forward into the machine, just to create more of a stretch on the lats, sorry, the upper back and lats, but more so upper back, to create more tension. And the main reason is to stop any momentum. So as we come into the hole or going down into the eccentric, we're stopping any kind of momentum coming through, so it's solely just upper back. I'm driving those elbows as far back as possible. So going into our last two movements now, we've got the low cable curl, which is chest supported, back supported, and then a seated dumbbell incline curl, which I'll show you top set on that. Three sets total on the low cable curl, one fairly light, one top set, which is like 6 to 8, and then a 20 to 25 rep set at the end. So, and then biceps is just one top set, one back off, and that's us done. Last movement, we've got the incline seated dumbbell curls, going on one top set, one back off, just getting a really good stretch on the incline, letting the biceps hang, and then massive contraction. So that is posterior done, we're finished. Great session. Got some good numbers up today, so everything was ticked off. Logbook was done, and we will progress next week. But no, good session. Talked you through it so you know what happened. Getting in post-workout meal now, 150 grams Cocoa Pops. One scoop of whey iso from Redcon One. Vanilla or peanut butter is the one that you need to try if you want to get some stuff from Redcon One. Probably my favorite protein, whey protein, to be honest. Just the digestion of it especially the isotope, but the isolate really does digest well, so we're going to get this in now, and then head home for, you could call it meal one or meal two, but next meal, there's our cocoa pops there, we're going to get this in. Appreciate you watching if you have got to the end of this. Any questions you have about the session or any videos you want me to do, talk about, drop in the comments below and I will get back to you and I will make it happen for you. But no, appreciate you if you even watched or got to this part. There'll be another video coming next week. And yeah, check out all the videos below that I've done in the past. I think it's been probably, I started in August, May, June, July. No, I didn't. I started in August, September, October, November. Yeah, so 4 months worth of videos, 3 or 4 months worth of videos there for you to have a look. Basically just me documenting what's going on right now. Every Monday there'll be a video dropping, so appreciate everyone who watches on the weekly basis. It's much appreciated. And yeah, hopefully I'm giving you some informative content that you can take into your sessions and into your bodybuilding, so that you can keep progressing. But I'm going to leave the video there. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you next week.